According to a U.S. Missile Defense Agency (MDA) statement released on the 26th of October, MDA and U.S. Navy conducted a successful test of Standard Missile 3, also known as SM-3 Block IIA missile. The SM-3 missile is an interceptor missile designed to take out medium-range ballistic missiles. MDA statement stated, based on observations and initial data review, the test met its objectives. Program officials will continue to evaluate system performance. MDA Director Lieutenant General Sam Greaves said, this was a superb accomplishment and key milestone for the SM-3 Block IIA return to flight. My congratulations to the entire team, including our sailors, industry partners, and allies who helped achieve this milestone. This comes as a big relief for MDA since the earlier test in June 2017 and January 2018 had failed. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S.-Japan SM-3 Block IIA missile shot down a ballistic missile. Let's get into the details. The test involved intercepting a dummy ballistic missile. This missile was launched from the Pacific Missile Range facility at Barking Sands, Kauai, Hawaii. The SM-3 Block IIA missile launched from the Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyer USS John Finn, DDG-113, was able to intercept the incoming missile. Hitting a missile with another missile is very complex. The incoming missile needs to be tracked continuously. Powerful computers are required to analyze the trajectory and extrapolate it with respect to time so that the future position of the missile in flight can be determined. USS John Finn, being an Arleigh Burke class of guided missile destroyers, is equipped with this kind of capability. The Arleigh Burke is the United States Navy's first class of destroyer built from the ground up to accommodate the Aegis combat system. The Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense System is an MDA program developed to provide missile defense against short and intermediate range ballistic missiles. Aegis BMD is designed to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and prior to re-entry. The heart of the Aegis system is the very potent ANSPY-1 multifunctional phased array radar that can detect and track hundreds of targets. Not only this, it can simultaneously provide guidance to SM-3 Block IIA missile. A traditional radar rotates mechanically and can see a target object once during each 360-degree rotation of the antenna. They need separate radar for target engagement. Unlike these radars, ANSPY-1 brings both functionalities together in a single platform. There's no mechanically rotating antenna. Instead, there are four fixed arrays that can send out beams continuously in different directions. So at any point of time, the full 360-degree envelope is being scanned. When needed, the radar can be programmed to direct more power in a particular direction. Hence, the ANSPY-1 is capable of more accurate real-time detection and tracking of target and is far more efficient than conventional radars. Being very powerful, the radar is very hard to overwhelm or jam. The SM-3 Block IIA missile is the most advanced variant of the SM-3 missile. All variants of SM-3 missile don't have own warhead and uses hit-to-kill approach to take down incoming missiles. The SM-3 Block IIA is being developed by U.S. defense contractor Raytheon in coordination with Japan's Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. Raytheon is responsible for the SM-3 Block IIA's certain specific hardware and system integration. Mitsubishi is tasked with the development of the interceptor missile's second and third stage rocket motors, steering control, and external structure. The SM-3 IIA missile has a maximum operational range of 2,500 kilometers. That's about 1,350 miles. Apart from being deployed in warships, it can also be deployed on land via Aegis ashore sites. In January, the U.S. State Department cleared a potential sale of SM-3 Block IIA missiles to Japan. The deal was estimated to be worth $133.3 million. The first SM-3 Block IIA missiles are expected to be operationally deployed by the end of 2018. For Japan, SM-3 Block IIA is a way to counter Chinese and North Korean missile threats. For the U.S., the importance of the missile has increased many-fold since President Trump has publicly stated that the U.S. will withdraw from the INF treaty because of Russian and Chinese non-compliance. For more details, please check the video on the above card. INF treaty, signed by Ronald Reagan and Mikhail Gorbachev in 1987, banned ground-launched missiles with ranges from 500 kilometers to 5,500 kilometers. Russia has responded by saying that it will also withdraw and develop intermediate-range missile. In this scenario, SM-3 Block IIA will be an important asset to neutralize Russian intermediate-range missiles.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.